Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about a chapter that is Animal Kingdom. This is for class 11th students. Okay. Before going into the topic, we have to know a term that is taxonomy. So what is taxonomy? It is nothing but the phenomena of grouping organisms. Phenomena of grouping organisms based on similar characters. For example, animal species on earth, they kept under animal kingdom. There are about 1.25 million animal species are kept under kingdom Animalia. Okay. Now, while reading this chapter, first of all, we have to divide the chapter into two parts. That is, first of all, the classification of animal kingdom. That means, in the animal kingdom, how many phylums are there, how many classes are there, how many orders, families, and how many species are there. That is the classification. But for doing that classification, what is the basis, what is the criteria, what are the characters they considered for the classification, that we have to see. That is basis for classification. So they have considered some important characters in each and every animal, and they compared with the other animals. If this animal is sharing the similar characters, this animal will be kept under one particular group. So what are that important characters? The first character is level of organization, and second character is germinal layers, number of germinal layers, number of germinal layers, and third character is circulatory system, and the fourth an important character, that is symmetry, and the fifth important character, that is coelom, and again some important characters like development, and next character fate of blastopore. Like that, they have taken into consideration all these characters. So we will discuss each and every character, what it is, which animals show which type of characters. Like that, we will see one by one. For example, level of organization, it has 5 levels further. So what are those, and which animals exhibit those 5? Like that. Okay. And number of germinal layers. What are the germinal layers? How many are there? How many types are there? So which animals exhibit which type? So like that. Circulatory system, 2 types, open type and closed type. So which animals exhibit open type? Which animals exhibit closed type? And like that, symmetry, coelom, development, and fate of blastopore. Like that, each and every character we will discuss separately. And then we will go to classification. How the whole animal kingdom was classified into different groups, that is phylums, subphylums, everything we will see. First of all, we will discuss these things. Okay. Now, as a part of this, today we will discuss level of organization. level of organization. Actually, there are several types in this. Those are protoplasmic level, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, and organ system level. Organ level and organ system levels. So what is protoplasmic level and what is cellular level, what is tissue level, like that everything we will see now. Actually, in the first video, in the introductory class, I had discussed about level of organization, that is the life starts from cell, the group of cells form tissues, the group of tissues forms organs, the group of organs will form organ systems, and the group of systems will form an organism. This one we discussed in the first class. So according to that, for example, the organisms in which only one cell, single cellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium, euglena, like this, these are single cellular organisms. In that, what happens, only one cell is there, and that cell is responsible for digestion, excretion, circulation, respiration, and reproduction. See here, the only single cell is exhibiting five different types of functions. So how it is possible? That means, for example, this is nucleus, and there are different cell organelles. Different cell organelles. Due to the interaction between all the cell organelles, the cell is able to perform in different types of functions. See here, only single cell, it is performing all the functions. How it is possible means, the cell organelles present in the cytoplasm or present in the protoplasm that are coordinated with each other and performing the functions. So here, the term division of labor. Division of labor. For example, in a school, the teaching will be performed by teachers, the administration will be performed by administrative department, exam department, like that the whole function of the school was divided by different departments. So like that, different functions are distributed among the different cell organelles. So this division of labor, that means division of work, is performed by different cell organelles which are present in the protoplasm or cytoplasm. So this level is known as protoplasmic level. Okay, so here this is not related to animal kingdom, because this protoplasmic level present exhibited by protozoan organisms. Protozoans. These protozoans belongs to kingdom Monera, kingdom protista. Okay, it belongs to the kingdom Protista. Now, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, and organ system level. These levels are exhibited by animal kingdom. Animal kingdom. What is cellular level? For example, in the earlier organisms in the kingdom Animalia, we have porifera. So here, these are the earlier organisms in the evolution. That means they are very smaller organisms which are having a few cells in the whole body. So they are exhibiting the cellular level. That means here, even group of cells are there. but they cannot form tissue. So what happened? The division of labor, the division of work will be distributed among different cells. These are exhibited by the phylum Porifera. Exhibits cellular level of organization. Okay, and next, tissue level. This type of organization is exhibited by the phylums, that is Cnidaria and Ctenophora. Cnidaria and Ctenophora. So what is this? Here the organisms are somewhat developed in that all the cells are combined or grouped together to form a tissue. So here the work was divided among the tissues. Okay, and organ level, this level of organization was exhibited by group of animals belongs to the phylum Platyhelminthes. Here the group of tissues are combined together to form tissue organ like structure, so they are exhibiting organ level of organization. And here some Platyhelminthes, and from nematodes to mammals, that is the most developed organisms in the kingdom Animalia, they will exhibit organ system level. All the organs perform the same function or come together and forms an organ system, like digestive system, respiratory system, nervous system, like that. Okay, they will perform organ system level of organization. Okay, this is about levels of organization. And second one, germinal layers. So how many layers of cells are present in the embryonic level, which leads to the development of different organs, different organ systems when the embryo will become an adult. Okay, if in the embryo it has two embryonic layers, that is known as diploblastic level. And if there is three embryonic layers, that is triploblastic level. Okay, here two layers, here three layers. So what is diploblastic level, what is triploblastic level, we will see. In an organism, the cross section of an organism, if it is having two layers of cells, an organism has two embryonic layers, the outer one is ectoderm and the inner one is endoderm. This is known as diploblastic level. And what is triploblastic level? That is, an organism has, the name itself indicates tri, di. Di means two, tri means three. The outer layer is ectoderm and the inner layer is endoderm. The inner layer is endoderm. Okay. But what is the third layer here? The third layer is formed in between the ectoderm and endoderm. The third layer is formed in between ectoderm and endoderm. So that is mesoderm. That is mesoderm. Okay, the third layer which is formed in between ectoderm and endoderm is mesoderm. But here, when compared to triploblastic level, it is highly developed layer. But here what happened, there is a layer like structure. There is also a layer like structure that is present in between ectoderm and endoderm. That layer is known as here mesoglia. Mesoglia. So how it is formed? See, is the mesoglia is same with mesoderm? No. It is highly differentiated from ectoderm and endoderm. But this mesoglia layer is somewhat the cells coming from ectoderm. The cells coming from ectoderm and the cells coming from endoderm. They form a different layer like structure. That is mesoderm. It is not a new layer. The cells which are, some cells are migrated from here and here and they form a layer like structure. So it is not a well developed layer. So here, that's why it is known as mesoglia. But here it is a distinct layer which is entirely separate from ectoderm and endoderm. This is mesoderm. Okay, this is the difference between triploblastic and diploblastic animals. And the third criteria, they are the diploblastic level is exhibited by cnidaria and triploblastic level. Triploblastic level is exhibited by platyhelminthes to higher animals like mammals. There are belongs to chordates. Higher animals that belongs to chordates. Okay, this is about diploblastic and triploblastic levels. And third character, that is circulatory system. Circulatory system means, we know, the system which helps for the transport of materials in a whole organism, that is circulatory system. Mainly there are two types of circulatory systems. The first one is open type and the second one is closed type. What is the difference between open type and closed type and what are they? We will see. Open type and closed type. What are the differences and which organism shows which type of circulatory system? That things we will see now. Okay. In open circulatory system, the blood which comes out of the heart and flows in the open spaces of the body, so that each and every tissue is bathed in the blood. But in closed circulatory system, the blood is not at all coming outside. No tissue is direct contact with blood. How it is possible? For example, in higher organisms like us, what is happening? From blood, heart, the blood is goes to each and every cell of our body through blood vessels and capillaries. The blood vessels are arteries. And from each and every cell, that blood, that used blood or deoxygenated blood is collecting by blood vessels called as veins. So here the well-developed vessels which helps in transporting or circulation of blood without coming outside of the and direct contact with the tissues, that is in present in closed type of circulatory system. Here blood from heart enters into open spaces so that tissues are directly bathed in blood. Here the blood never comes outside. The blood never comes outside. It is traveled from heart to tissues or cells through a specialized network, that is blood vessels and capillaries, So which type of organisms exhibiting open type, which organisms exhibiting closed type? This is exhibited by the phylum Annelida. This is exhibited by phylum Arthropoda. Okay, and then Mollusca, Echinodermata. These are the phylums present in the animal kingdom. Echinodermata and Urochordata. Okay. And here the closed type of circulatory system was exhibited by Annelida, phylum Annelida, and cephalopods. Remember, this is very important point, which belongs to the phylum Mollusca. See here, already I had written here Mollusca open type, but the only one class of organisms of Mollusca which is exhibiting closed type, that is cephalopods. Remaining all classes present in the phylum Mollusca exhibits open type of circulatory system. And cephalochordata and all vertebrates. What are all vertebrates? Fish, amphibia, reptiles, birds and mammals. All these type of organisms exhibit closed type of circulatory system. Okay, now before going to the next topic, I will give you the classification of animal kingdom. So how it is classified? Mainly it is classified into two types. Those are invertebrates and vertebrates. So what are those? Here it contains phylum Porifera, or here we can also call as non-cartates. Phylum Porifera, Cnidaria, Ctenophora, Pinophora, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda or Aschelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata and Hemichordata. Here chordates contains phyges, that is fishes, amphibians, reptiles, eels or birds, and mammals. So these are all present in the kingdom Animalia. Okay, so what is Hemichordata here? This Hemichordata, it contains some characters from invertebrates or non-chordates, and it contains some characters of chordates. That is Hemichordata, also known as half chordates. Okay, so now what is invertebrate or what is non-chordate? What is vertebrate or what is chordate? For example, if you have the vertebral column, that is our backbone. If any organism that have vertebral column or backbone, that belongs to vertebrates. If they do not have the backbone or vertebral column during their life period or lifespan, it is invertebrates or non-chordates. And one more thing we can consider, if the vertebral column is present at any stage on their life cycle, for example, if the vertebral column is present at early stages and then disappears at adult stage, that is one phenomenon. And second phenomenon or second case, if the vertebral column is absent in early stages but present in adult stages, that is second case. And third case, if the vertebral column is present all over the life period, that is both in early stages and in the adult stages. So any of these three, we can consider that organism or that animal under vertebrates. This is the difference between non-chordates and chordates, or invertebrates and vertebrates. Okay, in the next video we will discuss about symmetry, how many types are there, and coelom, and fate of blastopore, development and another topic, that is segmentation and notochord. So how it is developed and in which animals notochord is present and in which animals it is absent, that we will see in detail in the next video. Thank you.